Listen only mode.
Hello everyone, thank you for joining today's webinar. My name is Frederick. I am with the BIM 360 support team, and today's topic will be the Clash Pinpoint tool for BIM 360 glue. Before we begin, can everyone see my screen? You can just type yes on the command or on the question line on the webinar's comment line. Okay, so before we begin, so we've just discussed the topic and ground rules. So as I mentioned, today's topic is BIM 360 Glue, Clash Pinpoint Tool. This webinar will be under half an hour and will end by 4:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time or 1:30 Pacific Time. All participants are joined anonymously, so only I can see who are participating. And everyone is muted during the call. And at the end of the session, everyone can ask questions, and I will answer them the best that I can. If not, I will definitely respond back to you by email. So BIM 360 Glue is a very powerful tool. It allows project team members to coordinate in the cloud. One of the tools of Glue is the clash detection tool, which will allow team members to detect clashes pretty much from any stages of the project, from DD to CA. And what is included or what's provided for our customers in addition to to the Glue plugin itself is the Clash Pinpoint tool, which is also part of the plugin, and this is available for all of our AutoCAD products and AutoCAD based products such as AutoCAD MEP, AutoCAD architecture, and so on. And also it is available in Revit. It's I believe you can download it from 2012 to 2014, and for those who are using the 2015 products, it's available. Basically, it's installed with the product. So if you can see my screen, the one on the left is how it looks like in AutoCAD, and the one on the right is how it looks like in Revit. So to make this Clash Pinpoint tool work, there are basically four steps or process that you need to do in order to make it work. The first one is that the class results will have to be reviewed. When I say reviewed, you need to make a comment, send notification, or create a markup, or add notes to the class to be considered it being reviewed. Simply viewing the clash result does not mean it's actually reviewed status. And then you need to determine what the red model is and what the green model is. And basically, Objects that are in the red models are the ones that you can correct or modify based on the clash result. Any object in the green model will remain. And then the third one is, of course, once the objects, once you make the necessary adjustments to the clash, then you will need to update the model again in Glue by using the plugin, or you can also do the upload through Glue Desktop. And then once the model is updated, then of course you will also need to update the clash result in Glue so you can see the latest changes that you made. So now we will start with the live demo. So here I have a merged model. It consists of basically three models from Revit. One is the architectural shell, and I can show it real quick here. And I have the interior, and then I have the structural. So now the first step is to, of course, create your clash set. And just for simplicity, I'm just gonna select the arc interior model, and I'll compare it with my structural. And so I don't get many results, I'll just maybe select a few. Okay. And then I'll just name it Ant. Then I'm gonna run a clash. Okay. So here are my clashes. It has 17,176 clashes. I'll just select one. So it's basically showing just this entire floor clashing with this wall. Let's see another one. So same thing, it's just the floor clashing. So anyway, and then I will go back to my Revit model. And I have my structural model opened. So for those who are still paying attention and haven't fallen asleep, I'm sure you've probably caught at least two mistakes I already did, but I'm gonna proceed and we'll talk about it. So here I have the plugins, and I'll select the clash pinpoint. So as you can see, it says no clash results have been shared with you. So what was the mistake I made? It was basically, as I mentioned earlier, you have to first review the clash. You have to do something with it. You have to make a comment or create a markup, right? So, and even if I go back to projects, I select this. This is the project I have. It will still say the same thing. So let me go back to my clash, and I'll just create a comment. I'll just say, please remove floor to use the structural model's floor. So now I made a comment to this clash, 17175. And then I'll go back to my Revit model. And I'll go back to the project. And now I can see that clash that I created. Now, So this is the clash. I will select it so I can view it in this set. And I get this error message. The selected clashes are not part of the loaded model. Basically, what it is that, you know, on what I mentioned on my previous slide, you need to determine what the red model is and what the green model. So right now, my structural is the green model. So how can you tell? So when you're setting up your clashes, so the model that's checked in the compare column is your red model. And then the model that is selected in the two column is your green model. So basically, that's the model where you're not making any changes. The red model is the model whose objects you will modify in the clash. So now what I'll do is I'll go back and exit from here. What I need to open is actually my architectural model, which is right here. So now I'll go back to the plugin and open the Clash Pinpoint. So I have this clash right here, and I'll view it. And I can see the comment says, please remove floor. So if I click on view selected, and let's move this. So this is the floor. So just for simplicity's sake, I will just remove this. And do not worry, there are no actual projects being harmed while I'm doing this. So I deleted that floor. So then, the third item on the list I provided in the previous slide is to, now we need to update our model in glue. So now I can glue this back to my project. So this is the correct project. And while this is updating, I just want to provide some more information. So basically with Revit, once you update the model, the view, you can simply glue the model or update the model back in glue without needing to save your Revit model. Of course, it is always best practice to save frequently. Unlike in AutoCAD, in order to see your changes or the changes you made in glue, you first need to save the drawing so that it, you know, saves the changes that you made and before you glue or update the drawing back in glue. Similarly, if you're using the drag and drop method when updating model, to make sure that the file is actually closed. Otherwise, you'll see an error saying that that it is being used by another process, and that's specifically for AutoCAD drawings. Actually, I'm not 100% sure whether it's true for the other applications like the Tekla BIM site. So basically, I'm just waiting for confirmation that my model has been glued. So you can see here, I have a notification that I'm showing version 4 of 5. Although it's tempting to click it, you know, you will need to wait until you get that confirmation. from in Revit that the model was successfully glued before you open the model. Or you can actually, if you go back to your front page, you can still see it's still gluing. So you want to make sure that you wait that this is completed before you open the merge model. Okay, so now I got the confirmation. I'm just going to reopen my merge model. So the last step, so now we updated our model. So the last step is, of course, you want to go back to the clash result or your clash set. And here you'll see this orange thing notification that the model was updated since it was last glued. So if you click on this, so it'll give you the option to update the results now. So this is the last step that I'm going to make is to update the results since we updated the model. And this may take a couple of minutes. So while this is running, I want to just take the opportunity to thank everyone who joined and also just to talk about you can contact BIM 360 support. So for Glue, in the application, on the upper right-hand corner of the screen, you'll see this icon. If you click on the arrow, you'll get this option. And you'll see that there's an option to contact Autodesk. And then there will be a window that where you can submit a support ticket to us. Another way where you can contact us is via email. So email address bim360glue.support@autodesk.com. And you can also contact us by phone. And I guess there is a question where we can find this presentation. I will provide that information later on. I will send the email. And I will also notify those who attended today where we can where you can look at this presentation again. I actually don't have that information with me right now. And then you can also reach out in our forum. So if you type in http://forums.autodesk.com and look for BIM 360. You can also post questions in the forum, which is answered by other customers who may have experienced the same issue as you had, or may be able to answer the same question that you have. Also, my team in support also monitors that the forum. In fact, this week we are hosting what we call the Ask Me Anything or AMA. From today until Thursday, basically people in my team, including me, are monitoring all the questions posted in that forum. And we do that every month for a week or 4 days at least. And it usually falls on the second or third week of the month, I guess depending on if there are any holidays in between. And lastly, I want to mention, also in the forums, there's an option to submit any suggestions or enhancement requests for the product. So there's what we call the BIM 360 Idea Station. This is where you can post your any request or enhancement that you can suggest for the product. Actually, this is monitored by the product teams, including management. So those are just ways for how you can contact us in support. And let's see if how this thing is doing. So it's still processing. Yeah, so the time it takes to process depends on how complex the model is. Unfortunately, the model that I can find is basically a project I worked on a long time ago, and I've completely abused this model. So I have, I don't know how, like how much, I mean, I tried to clean it up as much as I can, but I'm sure that I've abused this model. So there may be things there that's not supposed to be there, which is affecting the process. But basically, once this is finished, what we're expecting to see is that the clash that we corrected will be basically recorded as resolved. So that's the last step that I wanted to share with you. So while we're waiting, maybe I can open the floor for questions. Does anyone have any question regarding today's topic? So again, there's a question about where can I get these presentations. I will, as I said, I will email you a link to where you can find this. And those who are interested, I can definitely send you that link. I don't have it with me right now, so but I will get back to you definitely. Any more questions while we're waiting for this to finish? So question is, can you compare the same model within itself? So yes, the answer is yes. So basically, if I want to compare my architectural model with architectural model, yes, you can do that. So basically, you will just select, if maybe when we get back to the settings, you know, you can select different segments or objects between the two and compare those. Yes, definitely, that can be done. Are there any more questions? Okay, I'm sorry that this is taking longer than usual, but it should come up soon. And I should have cleaned my model much better. But like I said, all we're waiting for is basically a result that shows that one clash we resolved will be in under resolved status. I mean, I would hate to cancel this one, but let's give it just a couple more minutes. But it should show up the results. Does anyone have any other questions while we're waiting for this? We still have about 7 minutes. Well, for those who joined, thank you. And I will, be online for the next few minutes. Hopefully the result will finish by then. But if you have any questions or any support issues, please do contact us at support. And let me just put up the screen again. And when contacting support, we highly recommend that you provide us as much information as you can. Usually what we ask for is the host name, and then the name of the project, and then, of course, the name of the model. Typically, we will schedule a remote session since we do not have access to the glue site unless the customer temporarily provide us access to their projects. But yeah, usually the first question we ask are, what the name of the host, name of the project, and those are basically helpful information to provide to us so that we can respond much quicker. Let's just check that again, make sure that's still running. So anyway, to know your host, it's this one here, the first. My host name is Frederick Regala. It's just what I lack creativity when I created my host. And then the project is this one, the second one. So the project name for me is BIM 360 bi-weekly training. And then, of course, the last one is the name of the model. So that's how you can distinguish or determine what the name of the host when you're asked that question, and then the name of the project. And again, I apologize, it doesn't usually take this long to run this. And I don't think it's stuck, it's just taking longer because perhaps I have so many objects in the within the model that I should have removed. Well, it's been running for at least a good five minutes. But I'm still pretty confident this will bring the result. We got 2 minutes left, and I'm still hoping it will pop out before we end this session. If not, I will be more than happy to provide everyone with a screenshot once the result pops up. And as I mentioned, it shouldn't take this long. It's just that I use a model that I've abused so many times in my test. And I just couldn't find anything that's more like a real-world application. But I could have selected a simpler model for this. Oh, there you go. So, as you can see, just made it within the time frame. So yeah, so basically the last one, the last selection that we did, the correction was marked as resolved. And if you want to review it, basically it will tell you it's been resolved. Comment, basically the object was removed. And that should be expected to when you actually run your clashes. And again, don't worry about the time it took, because again, as I mentioned, this model is just really an old model that I've been using since release 12. Anyway, again, thank you everyone for staying and joining into this webinar. Again, for those who are interested, I will send a link as to where you can find these presentations, these biweekly presentations. Again, thank you, and we'll see you again in 2 weeks.